Howdy guys, Kirk and Jason here with Kirk Giordano Plastering. Today, I want to mention something about failing fascia boards. Why? Because I was out here and I was talking to the owner and the contractor about why this happened, because I've seen it about 10 times easily, and we've corrected it just as many times. What we have here, they had, it's an old building, by the way, guys. It's a 100-year-old building, and we're higher than a telephone pole. I'm looking down on telephone poles. Who comes to a building four stories high and checks fascia boards? Nobody. So this is just a natural occurrence, guys. It's not like somebody did something wrong. What you have here is wood. This is a wood fascia board. And then they did come up here within the last 20 years, and they've seen a crack developing. So what they did is they put a piece of flashing on the top. And you can do that, and it sometimes works for a little while, but it's not a permanent fix. So when I came here before, they just had a little bit broken out here. And they said, gee, Kirk, what do you think? Should we just leave it alone, repair it? I said, if it were me, and from based on what I know, it wasn't this exaggerated. This is exaggerated because they've been pulling the stucco off. It was about like this. I put my whole arm, including my wrist, behind it. I said, guys, if it were me, this is what I would do, because the apartment and people they're living there. There could be wood rot in there. And even if there's not wood rot, what's happening is you have a shear strain. When they did this, they didn't have staple guns. They had furring nails. Now, the furring nails are supposed to be able to go 7/8 of an inch into the stud of the wall and to accommodate the width of the skip sheeting. So that's to hold the stucco up for 1,000 years. What happened was water did go in here maybe 40 years ago, and it started a crack here. And then the water started going in here. And when the drier conditions occurred, which on a hot day, 99 degrees, it baked this wall. Thus, the wood expanded. And when the wood expanded, it pushed the stucco over a little bit. And then you take that for 40 years, and what happens is now, the only thing holding this up is gravity. So the nails that hold the stucco netting on to hold this amount of stucco, which is 5 tons on just this one wall, are slowly collapsing like this. Again, it's nobody's fault. It's just gravity. Gravity's pulling it down. Would it last a year? Who knows? Would it last 5? Who knows? There are incidences where balconies collapse, stucco walls collapse. This was probably going to happen too. But I told him, if it were me, and you guys could afford it, take the whole thing off, because you might not like what you found. They took the whole thing off today. And that's not pretty, but it's a lot better than what I thought it was going to be. And then we have a lot more wood rot on the other side. It's typical. Water's been getting in there. You guys might say, gee, how do you take this stuff off? Well, my brother and I, we used to do it, and we would use these Hilti blades. You can buy Hilti blades, or you can buy diamond blade product. And here's the reason we'd use a Hilti steel blade or a diamond blade is because I've seen guys use these, and I say, guys, you paid $5 for that. You think you're saving something? You're not saving a nickel. In fact, you're losing money. Spend $100 on the best blade, because they're thin and they create less dust when you cut the stucco off, because nobody wants to inhale all this dust. And don't use a grinder, guys. I've had guys say, we're going to use a grinder. Don't do that. Don't do that. You make more dust and it's harder. So I tell folks, if you're going to take it off, and we used to do it all the time. I don't do it anymore. There's no glory in it, and I'm tired of inhaling poisons. But if you're going to do it, guys, do it in 3-foot sections, meaning cut a couple verticals. What we do is we'd start at the bottom, cut them, and then crisscross them, and the nails hold it in place. But then when you cut the wires, it can fall off. My brother and I had an instance where we had 4 feet by 4 feet, and we thought we were strong guys. Well, there was one wire holding it. Jay cut that, and the whole thing was too heavy for us. It fell through our hands, ripped our gloves. If we didn't have gloves, our skin, we'd have probably been at the hospital with stitches. It fell out of our hands, hit the straight bar, and went through a kitchen window. Fortunately, nobody was home. So if you're going to tear off, guys, 3x3, know what you're doing. Wear serious respirators, the kind that they use for, say, welding. Don't wear a paper mask. Anyway, guys, I thought I'd point that out, because I get a lot of this. In this week alone, I've looked at 2 where the fascia boards failed, and the people are saying, how come? I just had the stucco done about 5 years ago. It's a brand new house. The stucco cost me $70,000, blah, blah, blah. Why? I said, your fascia boards are failing. They didn't put the paper underneath it. So that's a building secret there, guys. You put your fascia board on top of a peeling stick and allow for us stucco guys to go up under it or you do it yourself, and when we get there, we go under it and save yourself a lot of this kind of hassle. But then again, this is a 100-year-old building. Anyway, guys, I thought I'd point that out because these folks asked me why. My buddy Larry Billman, 8 years ago, asked me the same questions. And by the way, the scaffold guys are the ones who caught this because their pins are 6-inch pins, and they couldn't even get through the stucco because it was like this. They're saying, hey, guys, we tried to pin the staging, but we can't get to it, meaning the stucco is separated. Little tips that unless your apartment owner or you own a house that's pretty high up in the air, probably never going to experience this. Anyway, guys, my name is Kirk, Jason on the camera. We thank you for watching just this explanation about failing fascia boards. And as usual, live long and plaster.
By the way, folks, my dad and I are now members of Amazon Affiliates, so if you're looking to buy any of the plastering or construction tools you've seen in our videos and you want to support us in the process, you can check the links below our video or you can go to our website and get them there. If you have any other questions for tools we don't have linked, email us direct and we'll respond to you then.
Once again, folks, we thank you for watching and I really enjoy all your comments.
If you guys like this video, please click the like button down below. And also, if you enjoy what we do, subscribe to our channel so we can keep making these videos for you.
My name is Kirk.
And Jay.
We thank you for watching. And from the entire Giordano family, we'll see you on the next one.